coming up, find out a little bit about Samhain and what's to come for our October Samhain series. Hey everybody, Bella Luna here. I am part of a trio of witches known as the Bitchy Witchys. We run this YouTube channel, plus we also do a podcast. So, this time around, I am here to kick off our October series on Samhain. So, we plan to do all of our videos for the month of October, plus our two podcasts this month around subject matter that happens during this time of the year. So first I wanted to start off with talking a little bit about just some background on the festival or celebration of Samhain. So the name Samhain itself actually does not sound like how it spells, because it's of Celtic origin, and it actually means summer's end, so it actually marks the end of the harvest. Now, Wicca later adopted many of the celebrations of the Celtic pagan religion, and so that's why you will see Samhain as a Wiccan holiday as well. So like you've probably heard us mention in the past, the Wheel of the Year is not universal to all pagan religions, so Samhain is particular to several pagan religions, but not all of them. So just to give you a little bit of an idea, for instance, for Norse pagans, there's what's known as Winter Nights. There's actually a Norse word for it, but I'm not even going to try to pretend to pronounce it, so just take my word for it. It's one of the times where they perform what's known as a blot, which is essentially a sacrifice to Norse deities or Norse entities. And it's to honor them, but also to ask for their blessings and protection into the harsh winter that's to come. So like Samhain, Winter Nights for the Norse also marks the beginning of a new year. In some traditional witchcraft paths, they have what's known as Gadrian. And I apologize for you trads out there if I am mispronouncing that. But that is also marking the end of autumn, the end of the harvest season, and it's a time to call upon the Lady and the Lord of Shadows. In Cornish traditional witchcraft, it's known as Allantide. And you now have the entry that is open between the world of the living and the world of the dead. So that should sound pretty reminiscent to you when we talk about this is generally thought to be the time of the thinning of the veil. So as you can see, many different pagan paths do observe that aspect of it. Now, there are equally a number of pagan traditions and pagan religions that do not have anything that is equivalent to Samhain. So, for instance, the Roman paganism, Egyptian paganism, Filipino paganism, there is literally no substitute, no equivalent. You might find some celebrations around that time, but nothing that is really similar to that. So what some people do is honor particular deities or substantial events or ideas, but instead focus on those deities of that pagan religion. So going back to the concept of Samhain, again, being the end of the harvest time, when literally things start dying that were once growing. And so one can say that death is in the air, so to speak, and thus why that belief and that feeling of the thinning of the veil between worlds. Now, what you'll also find is that many different pagan religions, they don't necessarily celebrate or observe it on October 31st. A number of people, especially in first world countries, tend to celebrate it on the 31st because of its correspondence with Halloween, but that's not necessarily the actual time and date of the celebration. So there are some, as I mentioned, that will celebrate it on the 31st specifically. There are many that celebrate it actually beginning the eve of the 31st into the day of the 1st. And again, with it being known as the Witch's New Year, kind of like how you would think of our calendar New Year, where January 1st is New Year's Day and December 31st is New Year's Eve. It's kind of that concept. Others will actually celebrate it over a series of days. And then there's other paths who will actually celebrate it on either the full moon or the dark moon that's closest to that time, that's closest to the end of the month. Then finally, there are those that are actually quite specific, and they will celebrate it specifically at the astronomical time between the autumn equinox and the winter solstice. So, contrary to popular celebration of most of the rest of the world that celebrates Halloween, Samhain or similar celebrations like that are really honestly expected to be a time of seriousness. It's not necessarily a time of celebration and time of partying. This is actually a time that we take very seriously because this is the time, as I said, when the veil is thinnest. This, along with the time around May, those are the two times during the year where the veil is thinnest, where we choose to commune and connect with our ancestors, our loved ones, and those that have come before us. So it's actually quite a serious time. And so one of the things that you'll be hearing about in one of our videos coming up this month is all about the Dumb Supper, and you'll be hearing that from Mountain Gypsy. And so that is something that a number of us do observe every year on Samhain, so we can commune with our ancestors. So, what are some things that are good to do during the whole course of the month, actually, not just around the time of the celebration itself, but during this whole time? This is a time when we are starting to do more reflecting and letting go and releasing. And so, any kind of banishment, releasing, reflecting, rituals, spell work. This is a wonderful time also for divination. So, if you don't usually do divination, this might be a time for you to start looking into it. If you do, then you're certainly going to be taking advantage of this time of the thinning veil to do your divination. This is also a great time to do shadow work. And so we will be getting more into shadow work this month as well. For those of us who work with ancestors, this is an excellent time to do work with ancestors. As I mentioned, that's where the Dumb Supper comes in. You can set up an ancestor altar if you don't already have one, or you can possibly redo your altar or change it up a bit. This is also a good time to embark on spirit work, and also a good time to hone in on any psychic abilities. And this can even mean just working on developing your intuition. So, what are we going to be doing for the month of October? So, first, for our podcasts, later this month, we will be doing a podcast on the history of witchcraft. And when I say that, I'm not talking about the Salem witch trials, because that is not the history of witchcraft. That's the history of European witchcraft. And probably a little bit of American witchcraft. We're going to be talking about the history of witchcraft around the world. Every culture has its own histories of witchcraft. And so that's one of the things that we're going to be discussing is so that you can all hear about everywhere else in the world, because not everybody is from Europe. And then the other podcast we'll be doing will actually be dropped on October 31st, and this will be on shadow work and what we are referring to as the lighter side of dark. So tune in to hear more about that. So as part of the series, you will be seeing videos on spirit etiquette, ancestor work, how to set up an ancestor altar. Like I said earlier, Mountain Gypsy will be doing a video on the Dumb Supper. I will give you a recipe and take you through making a Samhain oil. And then later on this month, I will also give you a couple of spells that you can do during this time. So I hope you join us this month. We are very excited to present this to you. So stay tuned, like and subscribe so that you can catch these videos soon to come. And we'll see you on the next video.